Let us prepare our hearts for worship and be informed that this morning is the first Sunday of the month and therefore prepare for Holy Communion. Let us pray. Dear Father, thank you for welcoming us into your house. We came from a world and honestly influenced by your world. We want to worship so we can walk by faith, so we can obey. Pave the way, Lord Jesus, by your righteousness, by the blood, we enter your presence in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Remain standing, please. Kate will be leading us in worship this morning.
Morning, church. Before we sing, let me read from Hebrews chapter 10, verses 19 to 23. Since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, and that is His body, and since we have a great high priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with a full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience and having our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope that we profess, for He who promised is faithful. Amen. Indeed, blessed assurance that we can call Jesus as our own and we are His. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, and this is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my of love. And this is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, and this is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior lost in His love. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. And this is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. You may be seated. We praise you, our Savior, wonderful and merciful one. Tempted to think that the determining factor of our lives are our circumstances, and how easily we forget of your goodness and your grace, and how faithful and how trustworthy you are. Lord, today we ask that this knowledge that you are with us will not remain only in our minds, but sink deep in our hearts, and that we may be always conscious of your presence and rest in it. For in you we believe, and we believe that you are able to keep us and hold us fast. May I ask everyone to please rise. I know not why God's wondrous grace to me He hath made known, nor why unworthy Christ in love redeemed. have committed unto Him against that day. I know not how the Spirit's move, convicting men of sin, revealing Jesus through His word, creating faith in Him. But I know I know not when my Lord may come at night or noonday fair, nor if I'll walk the veil with Him or meet Him in the air. But I know
as we worship the Lord this morning and partake Holy Communion, there is one element that we should not miss, and that is what? Homesickness. This world is not our home. All God's people say, one day we'll go home. One day we will all meet our Lord. Two ways. Number one, in death, those who truly receive Christ, death is a transport to heaven. But there's another one. To be raptured. No, you don't undergo death. When the Lord Jesus Christ comes again, we meet Him in the air. That's something. I don't know which one, but a pastor once said, what do you want? You go through death or wait for the rapture? The other one said, no, I want to die. I want to go through it all and then meet my Lord. Can we sing the fourth stanza again, and let the Holy Spirit cultivate that homesickness? I know not when my Lord may come. Amen. Join our voices.
I know not when my Lord may come at night or noonday fair.
Amen.
Nor if I walk a veil with Him. Or meet Him in.
But we can say from our hearts,
but I know whom I have believed. I am persuaded that He is able to keep that which I committed unto Him against that
Lord, we worship You this morning. November is a month of thanksgiving. Grant us a thankful heart. Redeemed people are grateful people. Lord, we thank You. Thank You for the chance. Now we're still alive. We can come to church. We still have the health. We still have the hunger to worship You. And Father, whatever happens in this 1.5 hour of worship as we look forward for Holy Communion, strengthen our hearts, Lord. Cause us to walk in obedience. We worship You, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. We humbly pray. Amen. Please all be seated. Moments from now, the church will turn into a big sanctuary, an altar where people pray. Somebody said, if you don't pray, the message of which is, God, I don't need You. I can handle it my own. That's not true. We always need the Lord. Amen. Whether there be no COVID, whether there be no problem, we still need Him. 2 years ago, life was so tough. Even now, November last year, bugat. Pero today, napag-isip-isip ko, I should not be grumbling. So many things have changed already. Today, compared 2 years ago, we cannot sing. Today we can sing. All God's people say, amen. 2 years ago, do you remember? I checked my cell phone. I saw this souvenir of you are now allowed to come in to church. Okay, register. Today, we come in and out. God be praised. Now, I don't know how to announce this, but I need to announce this with much caution, and I must say with much hope. Our medical team in the church, composed of doctors and internal medicine people, nurses, have agreed that starting today, wearing of mask is now optional in the sanctuary. So if you want to go to heaven early, it's up to you. You can get your mask. So, nung Ray Lim, you can get your mask now. Kay dugan ng ampo ni nung Ray. If you have cough or you know yourself, di ba kabalo man ka sa imong sarili. But today, it's just the rules have, loosen. You can take off your mask even inside the sanctuary. But the choice is yours. God, look. Wala mo, basta. It's up to you. Those of you non-vaccinated, it's up to you. Those of you who are vaccinated, bahala na mo. Basta katong mga giubo, dili pod magpatuya nga. Giubo na. Minu ang bunay. I mean, we're still in the pandemic, but it's just good to give thanks to God. Some things are lighter. Amen? Some things are lighter. And take note of the following dates to the women of the church. You have your November 19 Christmas fellowship. Maaga kayo. And to the men of this church, we don't care. We don't have any fellowship. Mga onrami, mga women ra na, no? Later na na mga men. Yung mga men, di manahilig og fellowship. We want coffee. We want to be alone. We're very holy. Pero na registration. Number 2, November 16 to 18. Mark that well in your calendar. We will have our annual church spiritual awakening. Why we need that? We need to be awakened by the Lord. Kaya kung wala na, our faith will die, will grow cold. So 3 nights, I don't expect you to come every night, but choose one night. I strongly suggest you choose the first night or the Wednesday. And on the 18th, we will have an ordination. Wala pa mo nakakita how a Baptist pastor is ordained. So on the 18th, two of our pastors will be ordained. The pastor of Samal, our outreach, and the pastor of Bulacan will be ordained on November 18. One more good news. The other Wednesday, the church dedicated, the Lord blessed us with a brand new Grandia van. To God be the glory. No? Na dedicate na, ulat na lang ta sa papers, then it can be used for ministry. On the side of the not-so-good news, please remember to pray for Pastor RC. He left for Manila yesterday because his father, who is also a pastor, is not really okay. Anything might happen. You know, life is short, and I think pray natin si Pastor RC. Dr. Jerry is not with us this morning, and he is at the Solid Rock Christian Fellowship in Uraya. Anybody of you residing in Uraya, you don't have to come here. There's a good church there in Uraya, and Chinese Baptist Church is also helping. Congratulations to Reverend John Gakasan of Emmanuel Baptist Church. He was ordained yesterday. Let us come before God in prayer, asking God to intervene. Daghan kay tag problema. Alam mo kanina, just to inspire you, sometimes ayaw na tayong maniwala ng miracle. Ako, I still believe in miracle. All God's people say, not in my term, but in God's term. That's why I still pray. After the service this morning, Kuya Tony Gitarte came to me and shared something about pandemic. He was ayang liver, ay bukol. And he already said goodbye to his family, blah, blah, blah. And then he prayed, asked God for mercy. Happiest person in town, this morning he reported that the last check-up, scanned again, even the doctors were surprised. The bukol is gone. To God be the glory. Great things He has done. Amen, amen. Maka-inspire, no? Of course, there are those who did not make it, but the point is, why are you ashamed to call on your Heavenly Father? Say, God, I'm sick. Please help me. Lord, I'm really depressed. Please help me. When you call upon the name of the Lord answers. Let us all give the glory to Him. All rise, please. One of our favorite worship song in this church. Sing it from your heart, preparation for prayer, and then communion later on. Father, we love you, and we worship you this day. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Gratitude. From now, Heavenly Father, your children will enter your throne. And along with that, dala po namin yung aming mga mabibigat na mga problema. Kasali po dyan yung emotional problem and somehow people experiencing depression and a lot of issues in the heart. We don't even know what is the name. Lord, we want to cast all our cares upon you. Hallelujah, for you care for us. And Lord, as we are so preoccupied in telling you our problems, Would you also please remind us to listen because you are saying something? You are whispering words of hope. You are telling us what to do, where to take the next step, where is the next step and the next stop. Lord, hear our prayers. Father, I ask you now, in the name of Christ, welcome your children, our groanings, our pain, our requests, our long list of prayer items. Lord, have mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Please take your seats and let us spend the next few minutes in prayer. Tell God what you need. Give thanks. Surrender to the Lord. Especially if you are sick, God still heals. Amen. Maluluyon gyud ang Ginoo. Call upon His name. Surrender that problem to God and He hears our prayer. My help in times of need. Thank you, Lord. Abba, I pray that you guard us the confidence, the courage to ask for prayer because we are part of the community of the redeemed. In Jesus' name, amen. I don't know why there is such a heavy impression in my heart since 7 a.m. service. And then I talked to Mr. Guitarte kanina and begin to realize maybe it's connected. There's a lot of prayer requests I want you to respond to, but especially if it concerns your health, don't be embarrassed to ask for grace. Anybody here who needs prayer, especially concerning your health, will you stand? Let us ask God for mercy. Maybe you need to, or so worried about your health. Dili ta maulaw, mangayo tag kaluoy ba sa Ginoo. Lord, help us. Yeah, young or old. Diba? Abba is good and a healer. Anyone else who has prayer requests besides health, stand and be prayed for. Maybe a problem, maybe a trial that you're undergoing. Maybe a decision you need to make. Lord, we dili nami maulaw mo tindog. Especially unahaw na mo Ginoo ang mga lawas nga nagdaot our bodies when you reach the age 50. Actually, it starts 40. All those signs of deteriorations are undeniable. But Lord, if you still have a purpose in our lives, please extend it. Grant healing. And Lord, grant us faith to believe, wisdom to take care of our bodies, and the reason we live, amen, is to worship you. So God, I pray, in the mighty name of Jesus, release your healing. Like Tony, release your healing. For those who are, especially those who are in pain, God, be merciful. Others are standing because of many other complications in life. Sayod ka na Ginoo. I pray for your peace. I pray for your grace. I pray for deep reflection. that the goodness and kindness of the Lord will lead us to repentance. In the name of Christ, humbly, humbly, humbly we pray. Amen. Please be seated. This time I want you to pray for others who are suffering. Maybe you know someone. Ako, my heart is stirred to pray for Pastor Arcy and what's happening in his dad. Pray for a victim of the typhoon. People who are suffering. Maybe anybody who knows someone suffering, will you stand? It's not for you, it's for a friend. Lord, I stand for this person. Maybe as I'm speaking now, the Lord pops a name in your mind. You know what's the meaning of that? You need to stand and pray for that person. Because the Lord is assigning you an assignment to pray. Ang ano mang imong nahuna-hunaan. So you can pray. Amen? Yes. Respond to the Lord. It's a matter of life and death in a sense because somebody prayed for you. I'll wait. Are there anyone else that God stirring your heart? Lord Jesus, we stand for these names. Will you please give God the names that you are... He knows it already, but we acknowledge, Lord, that you know. For Pastor Arcy and whole Chan family as they face this difficult corner in life, hear our prayer. For Chan Bokso, I pray. We have served you well. Pray for your mercy. We lift up in prayer, dear ones who are suffering, those who are depressed, and those who are having mental anxiety, comfort upon the Marasigan family who lost Nong Roger, and comfort upon the Herrera family who lost Maning, comfort for the Pasya family who lost Karomi. O Lord, when there is birth, there's also funeral. And in the middle of this, maunsa na lang kung wala ka. How can we handle all of this? Father, we pray now, have mercy. In the name of Christ, humbly we commit all of this. Amen. Amen. All rise, please. Kate, will you come back here and lead us in this beautiful song? Timing kayo ni sa wali. Sing it with conviction. Not the strength of the Lord. We all need that. Amen? We all need that.
Sometimes life seems like buzz and music that can't quite become a song, so we cry inside and we try it again and wonder what could be wrong. But when we turn to the Lord at the end of ourselves, like we've done a time or two before, find His truth is the same as it's always been. We'll never, we'll need more. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. He's all we need for our every need. We never need be alone. Still He let us go if we choose to of the pain we find ourselves in, there are places to gain the wisdom to say, I'll never leave him again. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord.
All God's people say, amen. Lord, we need your strength. Please remain standing. Join me as we read God's word together, and we want to read it all together. Join us in the reading. Revelation 3:7-13. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Write this letter to the angel of the church in Philadelphia. This is the message from the one who is holy and true, the one who has the key of David. What he opens, no one can close, and what he closes, no one can open. I know all things you do. I have opened a door for you that no one can close. You have little strength, yet you obeyed my word and did not deny me. Look, I will force those who belong to Satan's synagogue, those liars who say they are Jews but are not, to come and bow down at your feet. They will acknowledge that you are the ones I love. Because you have obeyed my command to persevere, I will protect you from the great time of testing that will come upon the world to test those who belong to this world. I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have so that no one will take away your crown. All who are victorious will become pillars in the temple of my God, and they will never have to leave it. And I will write on them the name of my God. They will be citizens in the city of my God, the new Jerusalem that comes down from heaven from my God, and I will also write on them my new name. Anyone with ears to hear must listen to the Spirit and understand what he is saying to the churches. This is the word of God. This is the word of life. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please be seated. We have journeyed through the seven churches of Revelation, and now we are on the sixth church, Philadelphia. Next Sunday, when you come back, we will talk about the church of Laodicea, and that is the last church of the churches in Revelation. I'm very excited to preach about Philadelphia, for one, because this inspires me to obey God. All God's people say, there is one key word na dapat natong timan-an, tandaan, the whole sermon. Obedience. God honors obedience. Amen. Secondly, as you listen to God's word today, do not forget to connect the message to the communion. Because when we partake communion, the symbol of God's, Jesus' body and the symbol of his blood, you don't only ritually partake. You get into it, you know? They are symbols. But the sins of the evangelical is that we limit the power of God. He can make the symbol do something beyond symbols. Wow. Meaning, the mystery of the communion. So when I partake today, my heart will say this, Lord, like the Philadelphian church, I want to be an obedient child of God, all God's people say. And if you are part of this church, we are all part of Chinese Baptist Church, we must also desire that we become an obedient church. Reading the Lord's commendation to the obedient church of Philadelphia somehow stirs kind of envy in the heart. Why is that? Because nowadays, obedient churches are very rare. Am I right? There are popular churches, there are big churches, there are charismatic churches, but what God wants is an obedient church. An obedient church is not necessarily big and powerful. Philadelphia, according to Dr. Charles Swindoll, is a small church with small resources but enormous impact in the community. The more you try to explain that, the more you are confused because it is not meant to be explained. There are two churches so far that got the commendation from the Lord without criticism. They are the Church of Smyrna and the Church of Philadelphia. As we probe through the profile of Philadelphia, it is good to reverently remember Smyrna. Bakit po? Smyrna and Philadelphia were persecuted, expelled from their Jewish communities because of their faith in Christ. Let me remind you, when you obey God from your heart, obedience has its own consequences. Amen. God honors obedience, but somehow your obedience to God will cost you something. It might cost you loss financially because you obeyed God. It might cost you not to accept that promotion because you obeyed God. Ibig sabihin, we do not obey God because of the promised blessing. We obey God because He is honored when we obey. See, the Church of Philadelphia and Smyrna are connected. The scars of Smyrna are God's preparation for the crown of Philadelphia. I have a strong feeling that the sufferings God allowed, whether ikaw ang may sala, immaterial, the sufferings that God allowed are contributory to your obedience to God. All God's people say. It is in the time when you are so grieving and wounded that it becomes so clear to you that the next step must be the step of faith and obedience. The Lord introduced Himself as the one who hold the keys, the one who open and close doors. Please read the verse with me. This is the message from the Lord, the one who is holy and true, the one who has the key of David. What He opens, no one can close. What He closes, no one can open. Isn't that a timely message for those of you who are trying to open doors that God closed? Or trying to close doors that God opened? Don't do that. An obedient church, an obedient Christian will not intervene. Whatever God wants to open, He opens. Whatever God wants to close is to close. In fact, any suggestion to the Almighty is borderline to blasphemy. My prayer, dili mangutak haulat. We want the door to be open. You know, some people, I love that verse, Pastor. I love that verse. I know where you're coming from. Because at the back of your mind, you're saying, God will open the door. Tama, but it's not complete. God will also close. Amen. Sometimes, we are more expectant on the open doors and we don't appreciate the closed doors. No, they are equally a blessing if God is doing it. Amen. If you are doing the opening, if you are doing the closing, then be afraid. The Lord introduced Himself as holy and true. Means the Lord's commendation to Philadelphia is not based on their merit, but it is based on God's character of holiness. Ang pasabot lang ni Anna, whenever the Lord commends you, you cannot glory on it. You can only bow down to God who commended you. Amen. The reason why God commended the Church of Philadelphia, because those two churches never lifted up themselves. It is the Lord who said, you are an obedient church. There's one thing I want you to understand as we partake communion. Communion reminds us to wait. Communion reminds us to worship. Communion reminds us to walk in obedience. A timely reminder, a timely lesson for us that serving God with a hidden motive of self-glory cannot stand in the presence of the Holy and True One. I want you to read a verse from 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and then verse 17 and 18. Nahon na to ang 17. Read with me. 1, 2, 3. As the scripture says, if you want to boast, boast only about the Lord. Amen. All boasting must be confined there. Anything outside that is not walking in obedience. All boasting must be confined there. Your blessing because of the Lord. Your health because of the Lord. Your ability to endure suffering because of the Lord. In verse 18, we need to read that all together. When people commend themselves, it doesn't count for much. The important thing is for the Lord to commend them. The first part is a timely rebuke. For this generation who is so bright, so subtle, so addicted to self-commendation. You know? Are you in Instagram? I am. Are you in Facebook? Many of you are. The moment you are doing that to commend yourself, I think you will not enjoy that anymore. Copy that? You only enjoy that because you honor the Lord. Sa kinabuhi, maugi hapon. If your goal in life is to be pleased and to be honored and to be recognized, Lord have mercy, you are not walking in obedience. Amen. If the church goal, Philadelphia has no goal to be known, has no goal to be advertised. In fact, to be honest with you, one of the things that this church is really, really struggling is the live streaming. Long time ago, we don't have that. But because of the pandemic, we originally planned that after COVID, no more live stream. But the deacons reminded me, it's not really much of your choice. The live streaming is being used by God all over to bless many people. But even that, we should be careful that this multimedia, social media opportunity is not a means to commend ourselves. When we partake communion, let us check our hearts. Let us listen to the Holy Spirit. What acts today? What motives in the heart we cherish that we are not aware, or maybe we are aware, or maybe we are so stubborn that we really want to commend ourselves? Iba kasi yung the one the Lord commended. Amen. Sabi saya pa ko ang Ginoo ang motuboy nimo, makasiguro gayud ikaw nga walay politika o walay atik-atik. Amen. When the Lord said, obedient Philadelphian church, He's not playing politics. The commendation of the Lord will not lead you to self-praise. The commendation of the Lord will lead you to bow before Him who commends you. Amen. The reason why God blessed you, the reason why God favored you, so that you would bow more and know Him in worship. The Lord introduced Himself as the one who opens and closed doors. I need you to reflect on that. Who opens the door? Who closes the door? God. Amen. Somehow, our marketing strategies are needed. We need to do this. We need to do something. I understand that completely. But this morning, be reminded that ultimately, it is God who opens and closes doors. Amen? You don't believe me? Why was your flight canceled? You don't believe me? The contract is supposed to be signed. Wala na dayon. You don't believe me? You're not from Davao. You're from Cebu. You're from other place. You're from other country. Why are you here? Someone must be bigger than you directing your steps, all God's people say. In other words, closing a timely message for us to put off any attempts of bribing God into opening and closing doors. Get it out of your mind. I will give tithe so that God will open more door. No. God is sovereign. He is in charge. He opens, He closes. And He does not need your advice nor assistance. This reminder puts us in focus of serving Christ without, can you read that? Personal agenda. Alam mo, one of the things we need to surrender to God before we partake communion, our selfish agenda. Dili klaro ang himaya sa Ginoo because this selfish agenda governs us. And you are not into deep, authentic relationship. All relationships are shallow, if not fake, because of selfish agenda. This week, I'm trying to reflect. Kana bitang, you just want to be nice to someone without agenda is liberating. Amen? You just want to help without a motive of being helped back is liberating. And the opposite is true. The moment you serve God inspired by personal agenda, you are not walking in obedience. It is good to ask ourselves, why am I nice to this guy despite I don't like him because he is a sponsor, something like that. Why am I not nice to this person? And the more you listen to the Holy Spirit, you realize, mauday wa kayo koy amigo. Mauday wala kayo koy impact sa relationship. Is that because you're, what do you call that, introvert, shy? No, I'm not talking about that. That's personality and that is God-given. You don't need to change that. But if you have personal agenda worshipped in your heart, you cannot walk in obedience. The church must surrender our agenda. Ang problema, as the church is blessed, God's agenda is set aside. I say that as a warning. As the Lord bless us from a small church to a big church now, may we never forget that the agenda of God is still the main thing. Maybe you have forgotten. The church is not the building, it's the people. All God's people say. The church is not China, Chinese Baptist Bank, Chinese Baptist Church. Meaning the more money you have in the bank, the more sinful we become. All monies should be released for ministries and for helping the poor and the cause of Christ. All God's people say. Listen to me, people of God. As we go through the lesson this morning about the Philadelphian church, tulo ka mga tema, three themes that I want you to understand or at least consider reflecting. Theme number one, the sovereignty of God. Ang meaning po niyan, you're not in charge, God is. Amen. So ato ng bawasan, buhinan, ang ato mga dialogue na kung ako pa, nanay usa ka problema, dili ikaw. Kung ako pa, kung ako pa, kung ako pa, kung ako pa, ang Ginoo ko'y ambisyoso. The sovereignty of God melts your pride, expands your faith, and puts you in your proper place. You're not the opener or the one who opens or closes the door. That is God. Amen. COVID captivity, God closed a lot of doors and yet opened a lot of doors too. You know, it's a mystery beyond my understanding. Number two is bugat. The mystery and ministry of suffering. You know, suffering is mysteriously connected to obedience. When people are not experiencing what you call trials of faith, obedience is affected. Amen. The reason why God allowed those things that, Lord, ganong imo man ang gitugot, oy, it's a time to be trained in the school of suffering so that our obedience will not be inspired by our determination but be inspired by our powerlessness. Number three is a wonderful theme, the blessings of obedience. Now, you cannot erase from the scripture, you cannot hide, it is written all over the Bible, God honors those who honor Him. All God's people say, God honors those who honor Him. Why are you blessed? Di man kay ko Dios nun, pero anong na-appeal man ko, haven't you not researched? Your parents honored God. Nadamay ka. All God's people say. I mean, God honored those who honor Him. You can see that in your reunions when you have your high school reunion or your friends. I am not asking you to measure people by the money they own, by the wealth they have, but the obvious hand of God in that person. Wa mo gini say, wala gini say, ambot ni akong amigo, wa gini. Natingala jud ko ba? Nganong natingala jud ko ba? That's the way God honors you. It's not about you. And you are a shock to others. They can't even believe that it's happening because it is the Lord honoring you. Amen. I have seen that. I have seen that in many young people, small children in church. Now you meet them and now they say, I am this and I am that. And you realize, wow, po ko natingala, ani, the Lord honored this. I have seen that. In the many families I have known who have taken God seriously, God honored them. And I have seen that in churches who mysteriously, and I shall say miraculously, blessed by God, not because of their media advance or their technological strategy or good people, professionalized ministers. No, it's just different when God honors a church and when God honors a person. Now, let's look at Philadelphia. There are three things that I describe to you how God honored this obedient church. Number one, the spiritual breakthroughs of the Church of Philadelphia. When we say spiritual breakthrough, it's another word for open doors. The Lord opened the doors. Did you get that? If God opened the door, don't mind guarding it. Nobody can close it. Amen. Sleep tight. Sleep well. When God closed the door, nobody can open it. Now you know who to trust. Now you know who to call. Now you know who to depend on. I know all the things you do, says the Lord. I have opened the door for you and no one can close. That's a breakthrough. Keep reading. And the Lord said, you have little strength. You know that's a breakthrough? You have little strength. The moment you admit, the moment you understand how little is a polite word to say, you have no strength. That's a spiritual breakthrough. And Ina, we have all sung the song, The Strength of the Lord. Favorite niyan ng Chaibap. It's our journey. Pero I have a feeling that individually, iba-iba ang kanta natin doon. Kasi iba-iba ang ating pinagdaanan. Tama po ba? Pero, yung mga kapatid na umaamin, you acknowledge how little is your strength. You realize that's a spiritual breakthrough. The moment you admit you're weak, you are starting to walk in obedience to God. All God's people say. The moment you start to boast that you can obey, I can handle that, you just disobeyed God. God said to Philadelphia, I know your little strength and the mystery and tension of this. How can a church with little strength obey and not deny the Lord? The secret will be revealed later. One of the breakthroughs that God gave Philadelphia is, look, verse 9. I will force those who belong to Satan's synagogue, liars who say they are Jews but are not, to come and bow down at your feet. That's something. Keep reading. They will acknowledge that you are the ones I love. Ano ibig sabihin po nun? Are you aware that when you obey God, you will not gain popularity, prepare for persecution? All God's people say. When you really, really obey God, do not expect for order. Expect for holy chaos. Now, just to set the record straight, are you really obeying God or are you obeying your pastor? There's a difference. Copy that? Some of you are saying, I'm obeying God, but in reality, you are obeying your discipler. You are obeying your pastor. Not counted. Only God be obeyed, all God's people say. Are you really obeying God? That's a deep thing. And as the Church of Philadelphia obey God, one of their, sa ako alang niya, pinaka-danlog, Bisaya, nagyod na, danlog, slippery, madulas, na blessing is when the Lord finally said, those critics of yours, those who persecuted you, those who maligned you over Philadelphia on Facebook, I will shame them and I will cause them to bow down to you. Kana mo, hindi na to kaya. I mean, I think you can handle the persecution, believe me. But when your persecutor is now on your mercy, that's another story. Listen to me. you need God more. Amen. Because the vindictive venom of vengeance, only God can suck it off from you. Joseph is my guy. You know the story of Joseph. And then finally the brothers were there. That's the hardest moment in Joseph. Thank God his obedient heart led him to see not just a moment of revenge, but he saw the big picture. Amen. The big picture. What is the big picture? The boy went to meet Jesus with his lunch. What is the big picture? That lunch is to be shared for everybody. Amen. What is the big picture? You finish medical school and you ask for prayer and God allowed you to pass the board because of the pandemic. What mag- Okay, ka nag-study, pero kapasa ka. Inuod ba ni Lord? Mauman ang grasya, no? But look at the big picture. You're now a doctor. You're now a lawyer. What is the big picture? So you can serve others. Do not have a franchise of blessing and patent on your own. That's not walking in obedience. It is always connected to others. So how did God bless the Philadelphian church? Here you see the sovereignty of God and the response of man complementing each other. Now, let me explain to you. God is sovereign. Amen? And because God is sovereign, He decided, He designed that you and I will have free will. All God's people say. Ibig sabihin, listen carefully. Listen carefully and don't get this wrong. No one should be forced to obey God. Forced faith is fake faith. Amen. Forced obedience is fake obedience. There's got to be, I will obey God. Saan nag-umpisa yon? God's conviction. Amen. From whom? Holy Spirit. What is the standard? God's word. Can I give an example just to make clear what I'm saying? I am not saying that, namagoy pangunta na pastor na may karinderiya, na maligya, may red horse, sanmig og soju. Pastor, we are a member of the church. Amo ba ning kuhaon? Well, the issue is more than liquor. The issue is deep. Can you honestly say, this is just a question, can you honestly say that by selling these things, you are obeying God? You need to answer that. Amen? So there is the story of a couple. Lumalago po yung kanilang negosyo na karinderiya. Pero ang problema, nagiging tapukan sa mga bata, lasing, hubog. Dakog kita, pero hubog ang community. Oh, they are believers. They belong to a very gracious church who never attacked that. But God convicted them. Where is obedience coming from? God's conviction. Amen. God convicted them. Husband and wife. Murabag wala gi plano. Dad, di naman ko katulog. Nga naman eh, they searched the scripture. And the scripture led them to a conviction that says, you must give up those liquors because it is harming the young people. Copy that? Hard decision. Get your abacus, get your calculator, get and compute that consequence. Because if you give up this, there is still a possibility that the karinderiya will be closed. Sabi mo na kung antuyo sa karinderiya sudaan. So, how do you deal with that? The couple decided to get rid of those liquors. And so you will say, but the Lord will bless them. Yeah, the Lord closed the karinderiya. He opens, He closed. Amen. When you want to obey God, there is a price. And no matter what the price, says my favorite pastor, Chuck Swindoll, obey the Lord. Amen. So how did God give the Philadelphian church a breakthrough? Number one, God knows everything. Amen. God knows everything. No need to inform Him. I know all things you do. God is not only aware, God acts out His plan. The Bible says, I have opened the door for you that no one can close. Now the secret is revealed. Why such a little church with little budget, with not so many bright people inside, can create a big impact in the community? The answer is crystal clear. The Lord opened the door. All God's people say, nga na ba, dili makatuo ang mga tao, dili man yun ka-bright, di pag yun ka-gwapa, grabe, Ginoo na yun na. That's the sign of a God-open door. Did you get what I'm saying? Kano mayon ka, oh, siyempre, anak man sa pastor. Oh, siyempre. No, if there is that trail of expectation that traced back to flesh, that is not God. That's what you call talent. That's what you call discarte. That's what you call, you know, skills. But when God opens the door, you might be amazed. Kagamay-gamay na simbahan. Grabe ang impact. Isa lang po ang sagot noon, God opened the door. Now, here's the one I want you to put to heart. Mga young people na nakikinig, the elderlies, you know why God still extend your life? Even, tigo lang na. Kasi sabi sa Bible, 70. Dapat report to heaven, ano? 70. Nga kay 71, 72, naapadyo'y 102. You know why God extends your life? This is my assumption. To still give you the chance to walk in obedience, all God's people say. Even if your life, you have walked in disobedience for those years, before you go to heaven and report to God, taste what it is to walk in obedience. Amen. Taste what it is to walk in obedience. For the first time. You see, I'm excited to expound this. God honors obedience. Amen. God honors obedience. Nakita ko yun sa kinabuhi ba? God honors those who honor Him. And as I say that, I dare not magnify your obedience. I would rather remind you that the opportunity that you can obey comes from God. Amen. The strength that you use so you can obey comes from God. What is the... So if you're doing the math, unsa equals, God gets the glory. Amen. Here we go. Sabi ng Bible, you have little strength. Yet you obeyed my word and did not deny me. Parang, paano yon? Little strength, pero nag-obey. Little becomes much when you place it in the Master's hand. Amen. Your little talent, God has used to bless many. Hallelujah. Your small Capilia church, God has used to share food. Amen. Your family, wala man unta mo'y, I mean, you're not really known, you're not even rich, but the influence, you have little strength. Pwede mag-sink in yan? You have little strength. The moment you partake communion, you partake as grateful person. God, I have no strength. The strength of the Lord. Amen. Here's the interpretation. The obedient church of Philadelphia did not boast on their strength. All God's people say, wala nang hambo. Na-disciple me, na-doktrinahan me, grabe among training. None of those. None of those. Our pastors, our caliber, top-notch, none of those. In fact, it is so clear to them, we have no strength. They have little strength. And that strength, and that little strength, is a spiritual breakthrough because they accepted their weaknesses. All God's people say, they accept their weakness. You know where obedience starts? When you begin to say, I'm weak. When you begin to say, God, wag mi kaya. This is too big for me. The church of Philadelphia obeyed and did not deny Christ. Why? The secret now is out. Because they availed of His strength. Amen. It's been quite some time now, though, ano bang tawag dyan? Automatic man now, eh, Lord, I need your strength. Parang i-pray bagad na every day. Balo naman si Lord, anak. Lahi yod. Kung muingon ka, Lord, I really need your strength. Amen? It's not gonna be just, of course, mute and academic. Given na yan. Hindi eh. Iba talaga yung inaamin mo na, Lord, magwali ko karon. Give me strength. Amen. Lord, I'm leading the songs today. I'm playing the keyboard. Lord, I'm doing the PowerPoint. Trabaho ko na to for 30 years, but God, I need strength. That is obedience. Amen. You're a surgeon for years, but every surgery is not a fuel of self-confidence, but rather dependence upon the Lord. Amen? Alam ko na tong lubak-lubak dito sa daan, mag-ampo gihapon before mag-drive because you are not really smart. Copy that? You have trials, you pray. Now you have blessing. The more you pray, because no one can handle those blessings without God's help. When I partake communion, I would say, Lord Jesus, you are my strength. As I eat this bread, strengthen me. As I drink the cup symbolizing your blood, remind me of my access to Abba. Third breakthrough, the Church of Philadelphia was vindicated by God. Wow! Siguro ang lesson lang nito, obedience to God is much needed when at that time in your life, you are now the one calling the shot. Hindi na ikaw yung api. Ikaw na yung may sinasabi. Hindi na ikaw yung church na gamay ra sa barangay 9, dako na ang simbahan. Nothing should change. All God's people say. Hindi na ikaw yung waiter sa kwan. Attorney ka na karon pero part-time waiter gihapon. Hindi na ikaw yung pipitsuging chipipay na nagkuhan lang diyan. You are now someone, and the Lord tells the Philadelphian church, your critics, I will cause them to bow down to you. But if you read the whole verse, they will realize, your critics, your opponents, the enemies of God will realize that I am with you. Amen. You know why your critics surrender? Di na siya mo laban nimo? Because for the first time, God opened his eyes and he can clearly see God is with that person. What ay kaya na ba? All God's people say. It's not really you. Diba? Your critics, don't be too offensive or defensive toward those who oppose the church because Christ will defend the obedient church. You see, A.W. Tozer, this revered Alliance prophet minister, said one thing to pastors, and listen kay apply, do not demand. Wow. Number two, do not defend yourself. But God is saying, if you want to walk in obedience, seek justice, yes. Seek truth, yes. But know the difference between justice and vengeance. God takes care of that. There's one verse I'll tell you. Vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. Romans 12:19. He will repay, not you. He will see to it that justice is given, not you. Ang pinakalisod, the hardest and the most danlog and slippery part of life is when the table turned. You are now the Joseph. There, you need to walk in obedience like you walked in the dungeon. All God's people say. Now you are the big church. There you need to walk in obedience like you walked before. Second, the spiritual depth of the church in Philadelphia. When you say depth, sabi saya pa, kalalum. When God measures depth, he is not going to measure your doctrinal knowledge, though that is very important. How do you measure, how do you know that this, the spirituality of the church or the depth of the church or the depth of an individual? One test, obedience. All God's people say, not just words, obey. Amen. Not just debate, obey. Not just beautiful robe choirs and eloquent ministers. No, obedience is what God desires. Look at verse 10. Because you have obeyed my command and persevere. Mga kapatid, we will not all understand the word of God. Until now, I'm still studying it. Wala namang master of the Bible, no? Pero God smells it. God recognizes it. God rewards it when a Christian walks in obedience. Now, my challenge to all of you. Kana bang imong ginahimo ron? The things you're doing now. Maybe you are a doctor. Maybe you're an engineer. Maybe you are doing whatever you're doing today. Can you honestly say with all your heart, I am doing what I'm doing in obedience to God? That's a critical question. You know, kanina, an old lady came to me and said, ang tagal-tagal na nila dito sa Chaibap. Ang tagal-tagal na talaga. And then she came to me, trembling, shaking my hand, said, Pastor, in obedience to Christ, I now want to be a member of this church. Amen. Is it in obedience to Christ I'm closing my store? In obedience to Christ, I'm breaking up with this boyfriend or girlfriend. Wag naman yan. Sali yan. In obedience to Christ, I'm canceling the contract even if I pay a price because it is not honoring to the Lord. Are you getting me? In obedience to Christ, ganun eh. The Philadelphian church saying, in obedience to Christ. And what is the meaning of that? Chop it to pieces. The spiritual depth of Philadelphia was not about words, it's about their wounds and their walk. Mabitaw gisulti na ako sa inyo, think Smyrna. The suffering of Smyrna humbled them, and the wounds of Philadelphia deflated the air. That's why they can obey, all God's people say. Spiritual depth, their wounds, ang ilang mga samad, were brokenness that reminded them of their very little strength. Mga kapatid, it is so humbling to know that whatever God allowed from January to November, 11 months now, whatever God allowed in your life, whatever God allowed in your life, is a timely reminder that you are not strong, all God's people say. Whether that is a blessing, whether that is a problem, whatever God allowed circumstances, ang mensahe lang yan, you're not strong. Their wounds were brokenness that reminded them of little strength. Their acknowledgement of weakness became their strength for obedience, which really came from the heart that fully depends on God who is strong. Amen. Alam mo, minsan nakakatawa. Just when the time you're no longer physically strong, just when the time your influence are dili nakalakas sa City Hall, amen. Just the time that you're already, kumbaga sa term na mga artista, ikaw ay laos na. Expired na. O laos na lang siguro. Just when the time that wala ka ng kakapitan, then you begin to feel the joy, the reality, ing ani daining musalig lang sa Ginoo, no? All God's people say. Give us this day our daily bread, not daily bakeries. Lord, one step at a time. I graduate lagi. Lord, have mercy. I'm going through troublous time in my marriage, but I'm holding on a God that is strong. Tama, pero dili kompleto. You know what is complete? The strong God is holding you. That's why you can obey. Their perseverance is not a display of their determination, but a testimony of their surrender to God's sovereignty. Morning kadaot sa daghang testimony. You know, somebody shares a testimony or even eulogy. You can clearly see the focus is no longer God. It's their good life, it's their determination, it's their tithing, it's their love for the church. Their obedience and perseverance are mysterious recipe of God-permitted collaboration that resulted to God's glory displayed through the church. I got this from Dr. Mulato's sermon. God is sovereign. Hindi niya tayo kailangan. Tama ba yan? He can handle it. But God is gracious. He invites us to join Him. Why? Kasi hindi niya kaya? No. Because He wants you to experience the beauty of walking by faith and obedience. Amen. Para bang bugat kayo ng piano, pero na may ligid. Dali na lang. Tama? Dali naman diyan. May ligid. Sabi mo na kung bugat ni, dali na lang. May ligid. Kung ikaw mananagat, if you are a fisherman, ayaw og bugsay sa low tide. Kaya kung saan niyong bugsay, di yun mo largang. Di ba? Kung mo larga man, o nilarga man lagi, try pa more. You know, the more it moves, the more harder you row, and the more you're tired. But fishermen would say, relax, wait for the high tide, wait for the tide to come, and when the tide comes, the boat just floats, and what was once so impossible to do comes easy. God collaborate with us, not because He needs that. We need Him. Amen. Bakit nakaya natin yung COVID na 2 years? Sige, di kong hugas, Pastor. Mao. Limugmog na na akong alcohol. Mao. Grabe, no? I mean, I know people, duha ka-extreme. May uban, Ginoy, bahala, sakuha! Dili ko magpabaksin, perting pataya, oy. Eh, ginuugi daw. Ako, mauba, uli na, bugiro na kay ka. Napoy uban, salig mata sa Ginoo, no? Pero pagsulod, hugas, pagsulod, bugahan ko. Grabe, murag nasa. Pagsulod, ubo, COVID gihapon. You know, COVID is really something. I mean, the lesson there is powerful. But you know what? You have to realize all of God's permission and grace, we survive. Amen. Number three, the hardest point, you have the spiritual depth of Philadelphia measured by obedience. Amen. Copy that? Next one. God gave Philadelphia special privileges. Take note, not rights, privileges. God tells Philadelphia, not Chaibab, huh? Philadelphia, I will protect you from the great time of testing. Wow, thank you, Lord, for that privilege. If not for God's protection, who can stand? Mama, I will come soon. Thank you, Lord, for the promise. Hold on what you have so that no one will take away. He will never have to leave it. I will write them on the name of my God, with the name of my God, and they will be citizens in the city of my God, the new Jerusalem that comes down from heaven from my God. And I will also write them on them with my new name. A lot of things there. Asailuag yun ko ninyo. Hindi ko na ma-explain. May bagong pangalan pala ang Diyos. I don't know. But it causes me to be excited to one day this will all be revealed. Amen? So, we can only take from the book of Revelation what we can chew for now. The rest, we have to take that by faith. Okay? Here is what we can chew. Because Philadelphia obeyed God and their obedience is a result of their availing of God's strength, God opened the door, and God released the privilege. And what is that privilege? Number one, the grace of God's special protection. All God's people say, protected by God. Ano makaingon ka ba nga? The most exposed, wala na COVID. Hindi natin, come on folks, stop explaining this. Because this is something we cannot manage. This is something we can humbly receive. Amen? Stop explaining. Nga nung waka nag-COVID, nga nung na-bless ka, quit the attempt to explain. You cannot. Chances are you will be proud. Just humbly receive. No wonder why. May I explain to you that after the service, I am asking you, lift up your hands to God before we go home, a symbol of saying, God, wala man akong, wala man kuy, di makukuyaw, but I humbly receive what you give before I leave church. Amen. A symbol of openness. This is something we cannot compare or boast about. Humbly bow down and worship. I did not hear from Philadelphia and they say, otanawa mi ha, obedient. Kamong Ephesian church, cold. Kamong Sardis, patay. The moment you are into comparison, you are not walking in obedience. All God's people say, you cannot compare. You know who you are. Kilala mong sarili mo. You know, salamat sa ginawa ko ng abit. Kabalo kas tinuod, hapit na. You get my point? You have the nerve to boast? You know the whole story. So, look at me. I've been holy all these years. Holy, wala ka na huli. Oh, hindi ka huli. Hindi ka na huli. Diba? I remember a pastor. That pastor na siya healing ministry. Healing? Kanang ayun, dili healing. Sige, pangayo. Ah. Maigsoon pa minaw mo, ha? Ay, kaliso, di explain na ning Biblia, eh. When the Lord blessed you, your first response is not to compare, to humbly bow down in worship. Kay nag-tight man good me. Mali lagi na. Tanawan siya, bab na bless. Ang alliance, wala. Di na tama. Don't stop doing that. You know, dire grabe sila prayer. You're not walking in obedience because obedience will not cause you to compare and boss. Obedience will cause you to bow down before the Lord your God. Amen? Sabi mo yun. You know, a story was told about Karen. Karen is married to Michael, and Michael is the most, sabi pa niya, oh, I don't really understand when the women gather together and ilang husband ingani, my husband is a saint. Wala gid siya ka-identify sa mga ubang babae nga ang ilang mga husband opposite sa saint. She doesn't understand that. And until the hard truth came. One day Michael came, show her the divorce paper, I'm leaving you and I'm now living with another girl. Michael's secretary, what I'm saying is this. It's too early to boast. Boast only in the Lord. Amen. Don't boast on your good life. Something can happen next week. Don't boast on your good health. Last 3 months ka pa nagpa-x-ray. Wala pa. Tomorrow, distingi. Mabitaw nang wala ko gawa pa-x-ray. At look, ay ko na, malabdes-labdes. Eh. Bukod sa takot ako sa karayom, takot ka rin sa resulta. Diba? Parang ganon. Ang punto ko, mga kapatid, ganito. You're recipient of God's protection. Don't compare. Can you say that? Don't compare. Please say that. Don't compare. Amen. When I take communion, I need to confess my sin of comparing. No? Now, this is something we cannot demand or be entitled about. We just gratefully rest under the wings of the Almighty. Amen. A second blessing of the Philadelphian church is the grace of being recipient of God's strength to preserve, persevere, and the grace of being recognized. The Lord said, I will write your name. I will write my name. You will be pillars. The victorious will receive recognition. Something to think about. This is something we cannot explain. But we can experience later on as we walk in obedience. This is something we cannot fully explore now, but we can be excited about. This is something we cannot claim as a patent, rather than this is something we can expectantly share with many others. Now, what's my point? Philadelphia, you are not the only obedient church, all God's people say. Now, it is good to say that. To yourself, you are not the only one saved, many others. Amen. You are not the only one blessed, many others. That's why graduations are very humbling. Kasi kung sa balay ka lang, nagtugay mong anak, tanong ka sa mir, salamat sa Diyos, to God be the glory, nag-graduate akong anak. Pero adto ka sa school, adto ka sa school ba, adto ka sa gym, tanawa ang palibot, daghan pod ang nakapag-graduate. All God's people say. You're not the only one healed. You're not the only one blessed. So we have no right to have a patent of the only obedient church in Davao. Maybe who God called obedient is a small church in Santo Tomas rather than Chaibab. Maybe who God called obedient church is a church that doesn't even have PowerPoint, but they can worship. Diba? Now I want to close. But I need to bring the message down to where we are. Nakoy pangutana, just a question. If you are from this church, you will appreciate the next points. But if not, bear with us. Are you a member of this church already? By member, I mean there are two ways to become a member of this church. Number one, by baptism. You have to be baptized. Why you want to be baptized? Because you are a believer. Number two, that's what we call statement of faith. I'm already a Christian. I am already baptized. I am from this church. I want to move my membership here. And then you sign the form and we ask you to join an orientation class and the congregation will accept you. You are now an official member of the church. And there is a third. You have been here since the Lord created the world and you assume that you are a member. Member ka lang gihapon. Ang punto ko, gi-categorize ko yon not to single out people. What I'm saying is this, if you find Chaibap as your home church, you're blessed here, you're fed here, you're sheltered here, kada Sunday you've been here, I think you will understand my point. Now, I need your cooperation. If Chaibap is now your home, if Chinese Baptist Church is now a God-given sanctuary for your spirit, for your souls to be fed and rest, will you say amen? One more time. Okay na to. Katong mga nag-amen, para ninyo, whether members or not, this is for you. Because party na kayo dito eh, di ba? Okay. We need to have a timely reflection for Chaibap as we reflect on the obedient church of Philadelphia. These are my reflection, and I hope you share with me because you've been here for a while, okay? Chaibap, like the church of Philadelphia, we have our own share of wounds that led us to acknowledge our little strength. All God's people say, we have a lot of wounds. Then we say, digiday tahawad. Amen? You know, ang joy ko as a pastor, not when I know what to do. It is painfully the other side when I say, kalisod, pastoran ng simbahana. Then I realize I'm walking in obedience. Now, listen to me. Those of you who said amen, this is now the question. Today, we ask the question, are we still aware of the reality of our being without strength? Before we partake communion, klaro pa ba sa imo? Satong gamay pa ta, weak ta. Katong dako na ta, weak ta gihapon. Is that still clear? Or something has changed? Yung med rep ka pa lang, weak ka. Ngayon, ikaw ng director, labaw ng weak. Ah, nga na, unta ba? Pero sometimes we need to ask the hard question, do we still feel the weak? Remember I told you last Sunday, when you see the building, remember redemption. When you see the cross, remember God's mercy. Do not remember how this church was built, the beauty, the magnificent design. No. You remember how weak we are and how gracious God is, all God people say. Number two, Chaibap, like the Church of Philadelphia, have been a recipient of humbling spiritual breakthroughs. Ang dami, the breakthrough. God opened doors. God vindicated cause are available realities that inspires us to obey the Lord. Did I tell you the story? Gamay pa ning simbahan, may Catholic madre, dool sa kuha. Madre yun. And then she said, I am sent by the businessman. I will not name the businessman. He said, gisugo ko pastor, o kung nabadaw kay plano na ibaligya ang church ko. Mother! Kasi, pastor, nag-research me. We found out, may na lang attendance. I can't believe what you're saying. You are a Catholic nun brokering for the rich. Long story short, I remember, Lord, you will not close this church. Today, I look back and I say, thank you, Lord. And I want to look at that mother. And I say, no. Reminder kayo sa Ginoo. Ginawa na may nanimba diha. Duha na lang kapantry ang buhi. 10 ka-member, natulog ang 9. Kabalo sila sa grabing research. Kulaka. But today, God opened a lot of breakthroughs. Question for us, you who said amen. Today, we need to ask ourselves as a church, are this spiritual breakthrough our effort or God's? God's. All God's people say. Amen. Dali lang ituklod, kay nailigid. Wala ang ligid, baguod. God's effort. God's blessing. God, is it still clear today? Hallelujah. Third, is it still clear today to us that obedience to God is our response to His grace, not as a result of our determination. Is BGGH still a living reality? You are from Chaibap. You should remember the sermon on BGGH, our series on Ezra. What is the meaning of BGGH? Because of God's gracious hand. We learned that from the book of Ezra 7:28. So I challenge you just to remind yourself. I don't know how you do that. Put that in your wall, in your computer, BGGH. Just to be reminded, crystal clear, because of God's gracious hand, nakalusot ta sa COVID. Amen! Because of God's gracious hand, this house was given. Because of God's gracious hand, I am still alive. And the list goes on. But I want you to read Ezra 7:28, okay? Let us read this together. And praise Him for demonstrating such unfailing love to me by honoring me before the king and his council and all his mighty nobles. I felt encouraged because the gracious hand of the Lord, my God, was on me. And I gathered some of the leaders of Israel to return with me to Jerusalem. Wait a minute. God is gracious to you. Why? So that God's purpose will be fulfilled, which is greater than you. Amen. Don't limit it to you, me and my family. No. God is gracious to you, to the boy, so his lunch can be used so that 5,000 will be fed. God is gracious to the widow so that his oil and food would be given to the prophet, and for 3 years the whole community is fed. And God is gracious to Chaibab so that the world out there might see the goodness of our Lord. Never forget that, all God's people say. Here's the last part. Today we ask ourselves, our gatherings of brokenness, prayer summit, spiritual awakening, spiritual direction, are they really a venue to meet God or simply an activity that maintains spiritual image? Karong November na atay gathering, ito yung mga tinatanong ko sa sarili, kung kaya nga nung kinahanglan yun. And I think I still have the answer, we need that because we need awakening from the Lord. All God's people say, we need that 3 nights of service because we have been sucked, influenced, immersed, hypnotized by the system of the world. We need to go back to God and say, God, before the world consumes us, awaken us today. The hardest part is the second. As I look at Chinese Baptist Church, kamong mga nag-amen, this is for all of us, it is humbling and refreshing good news that we are still blessed with the obedience of Philadelphia. If Philadelphia had open doors, let me tell you this, God's open doors are still open for Chaibab, all God's people say. How do I know that? Now, careful. Help me here. I will give you a list. But remember that the motive of giving you the list is not advertisement nor information. The motive is for you and I to realize that these things happened in our church because God opened the door and nothing else. Amen? Here we go. God opened door for compassion through the welfare center. God be praised. You know how the welfare center started? Ay nag-donate diri ka ng kape. Ang butangan ni mong 5, gawas ang kape. Tama? So, confused me. Saan man eh? May mga suggestion. Himo na tong Jesus. Para maang kita ba, simbahan. Napuyuban, asa tamang hagkape? Ang dami na. And then, wisdom from above says, tabunan nato ang 5, walay bayad. Here's the beauty. As the Lord provides the coffee is free for all. But some of the members say, paano kung mahurot? Maugani. If the coffee is not provided, then the coffee stops. Until now, you still have the coffee. Amukin sa mo inom, anak, maski hubog, maagi diha. Maoy ba? May kape, di kape. Mga gwardiya sa San Pedro College, mga street kids, the bad jaws, anybody, walay kape diha. Ilang taon na yan. Siguro, 10 taon na. The coffee. It started when the church was still kahoy. The coffee's still there. You know what's the meaning of that? The door is still open. Ano makaparking mo sa San Pedro College? Ay! Gakapi man mga gardere. Ito, gakapi. Ngayon, one time di ako, bawal ang U-turn! Sorry, sir. Uy, pastor! Gakapi ko sa simbahan. Kana, boy. Wala kami nagpalakas, ha? Ang punto ba nga, ang Chinese Baptist, sir, nagsugod lang sa kape, and then nanganak na, naging welfare center. How much we spend for the welfare center? 500,000 every month. Where did you get that? You see? Lord have mercy. The list goes on. God opened doors for communion through our worship, prayer gathering, especially awareness and awakening happening every Wednesday and Friday. Are you aware that this church is open from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m.? You can come in here and pray. And the awakening is ongoing. Every Wednesday morning, people gather for prayer, 6 a.m. Friday night. COVID affected ang attendance, but the door is still open. God opened door for having ministers who serve because they are servants and leaders who model obedience. This, I will go quick, fast, but direct to the point. I am proud in the Lord, BGGH, because of God's gracious hand. I want you to know that the pastors of this church, dili man mi perfect, a little na lang, perfect na. No. The pastors of this church, my colleagues, every one of us here, it's an honor to say that they are sincere, genuine, authentic servants of the Lord Jesus Christ. All God's people say, amen. The deacons we have in church, wow, I have pastored several Baptist churches and ambot na lang. I mean, you suffer in the hands of deacons. Grabe ang akong giagyan. Pero sa kaloy sa Ginoo, no? Open doors ba? Sa Chaibap, the deacons are amazing. Thank you for the partnership. And that's why we need to pray. God opened doors for mission. Next year, we start the work in Bohol. And we start the Badjaw work. The pastor for the Badjaw community is Pastor Bal. He will start his work January. Whether he works in Lucena or he comes back to Zamboanga, Pastor Bal is our pastor. Muhang yunta ko that because God opened the door for the Badjaw, can I ask you, pag may makita tayong mga kapatid na Badjaw, dili ta mag-put down? Amen? I mean, just remember that. If you want to give, give. Pero wala na'y pahabol bang, dago kayo maglawas. Ayaw na, ana. Tama na na. I mean, God opened the door and we should walk in obedience. Amen? Nor should we do that to any other race, Muslim or Lumads or what. Racism must die. God opened door for training of the marginalized, giving opportunity for pastors who don't have the money, but the theological training under this church, professors of competent head and broken hearts. I'm talking about Fritz Tong and Dr. Jerry. I have never met professors who are deeply competent and deeply down-to-earth, humble. God opened door. And Pastor Fritz Melody is still joining us soon, Lord willing. The sports ministry by Pastor David and Sam. Simba sa seventh floor. Basketball. You know, God is opening doors. A lot of young people coming back to church. Gigamit sa gino. Pero kanang basketball na sa tiyan. Scrabble na lang. May mga amigo ko, mga pastor, nag-basketball miss, pare, grabe kayo sila malikas, grabe kayo sila mag-ana, mga pare, di ko muting, ko, sa mga pastor, ang dama imong kasing-kasing. Eh, sa basketball, they don't curse, they don't do that, but the point is, when you play basketball, iba yan eh, it reveals your character, di ba? O na nga, pero, muna ang door nga gusto na ako i-close. Pero kay gi-open man ni Lord, so wala tayo mahimo. No? But thank you, Pastor Sam and Pastor David. Open doors for the PNP. Pastor Cecil is doing the Philippine National Police Bible study. Yung mga gwardiya dyan sa airport, siya naga-Bible study o sa katitipan. And then God opened door for missionary hub in Zamboanga. In Zamboanga, we have a hub there under Pastor Rara. This one I put last because this is the most obvious. God opened door every Sunday. God has used committed worship team who leads us in worship. Under the leadership of Kate and the volunteers, Lolong and the others. I mean, God opened doors. Amen? And then, of course, don't forget the people at the back of the booth. No? Kay katong tatlong Trinity dyan sa likod. No? Kasi si Jojo, Toto, o si Marvin. Mga balaan na sila. Actually, God opened doors. I mean, people serving for years, giving glory to God. My list stops there, but don't forget this. God's preservation for this church from ourselves and from the evil one is evident. Amen. Don't forget this. God's discipline is ongoing, delivering us from our sins of racism. God's purging, delivering us from complacency. If you are from Chaibab, kulang na lang mag-t-shirt ta. Kaya nakasabot yun mo ani. God's subtraction, delivering us from legalistic complication. 2 years ago, we cannot sing. Today, we can. God subtracted so we can focus, so we can obey, so we can avoid the drama, so we can walk authentic. As we partake communion this morning, today we partake communion. Let us all be humbled and be grateful for what Jesus did to us. All God's people say, the wafer is still the wafer, the juice is still the symbol, but when we eat this, mamaya, you realize symbol, but Lord, thank you for dying for my sins. Amen. As we partake communion, let us be broken in heart as we rejoice with the open doors and breakthrough. Broken heart, sincerely rejoice. Amen. Thank you for the story of the coffee. Thank you for the welfare center. Thank you for the ministries. But Lord, help us obey. Let us always live what we learned from Ezra. Because of God's gracious help, we are blessed. And finally, let us, amen, all of us, before you eat the bread, before you drink the cup of juice, offer your life to the Lord. If you're a young person, said, Lord, I'm 17. I don't know how many years left, but help me walk in obedience. All God's people say, Lord, if you have your wife with you, husband with you, pwede mo mag-commit. God, kami mag-asawa ba? We want to walk in obedience. Amen. Amen. You're a single parent. You've been through a lot, the worst storms in life. You've gone through annulment, divorce, or what. But you can still say to God Almighty, starting today, God, I help me walk in obedience. You're a store owner. You're a businessman. And then you want to say, God, this business is yours. And you're an elderly, 70 and above. You know, the quota is 70. 71 is bonus. Please say to the Lord, Lord, I'm still alive. Why? Give me a chance to walk in obedience. And together, as Chinese Baptist Church, inspired by the Philadelphian Church, God, we don't want to be sikat. We don't want to be known in Davao. We don't want to have millions of subscribers, listeners in Facebook or live stream. Our simple and deep dream, help us to be an obedient church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. All rise, please. Let us offer to the Lord this song before we partake communion. When we sing this song, surrender. Give up your life to the Lord and say, God, help me. Sa ko ano akong prayer, help me become an obedient pastor. Hallelujah. Life is short. Let us walk in obedience. From the balcony down, combine your voices. Offer it to Jesus.
We lift our voices. We lift our heads. We lift our lives up to you. We
are an offering. Lord, use our voices. Lord, use our hands. Lord, use our lives. They are yours. We are an offering. All that we have,
Jesus.
All that we are, all that we hope to be,
we give to you.
We give to you.
Humbly we say,
our voices.
2 years ago we cannot sing.
We lift our hands.
Hallelujah.
We lift our
worship you, Lord.
Up to you. We are an offering. Lord, use our voices.
Amen.
Lord, use our hands.
Blessed be
Lord, use our love.
Worship.
We are an offering. All that we have,
all that we are, all that we hope to be,
we give to you.
We give to you. Let us get our bread, our wafer. Let us sincerely pray. Join me. Lord Jesus, thank you for being broken for us. As we eat this symbol of your broken body, do something you only can do. Translate it to inspire us to obedience. Yes, we give thanks, but Lord, make me an obedient pastor. Make us an obedient church. In the name of Christ, amen. The Lord Jesus Christ said, "This is my body broken for you. Eat ye all of it in remembrance of me." Let us eat this in remembrance of our Lord. With a prayer, God, help us obey. Take your cup. And join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we are reminded today by the cup we are holding of the symbol of the blood of your Son, the blood that brought life spiritually, the blood that cleanses all sin, the blood that says we have nothing more to prove, everything is paid for. Lord Jesus, we are grateful. But in this blood, grant us the desire to obey. Grant us the strength to obey. Make us an obedient child of yours. Children of yours, make us an obedient church like Philadelphia to Christ our Lord. The Lord Jesus Christ said, "This is my blood. Drink ye all of it in remembrance of me." Let us drink this in remembrance of our Lord. Can you pray a prayer? Prayer that you, your own prayer. Prayer that tells God, "Lord, I want to be an obedient child. God, have mercy." Maybe your husband and wife are saying, "God, we will walk in obedience." Maybe you're already in the twilight of your life. "God, help me obey." God, as a church, "Lord Jesus, help us obey. Oh God, help me to be an obedient pastor, obedient husband, obedient Christian. Lord, hear our prayers. In the name of Christ, amen." Before I dismiss the service today, Kate will be leading us in the beautiful, very timely song. The Bible says, "Your strength is little." The altar is open, daghan man ta, no? So you cannot stay long in the altar, maybe 2-3 seconds. Kneel down and bow down as we enter this new month of November. Say, "Lord Jesus, I am weak. You are strong. But here's my life. Use it for your glory. That's the meaning of your coming to the altar. If you can still kneel down, fine. If not, just stand there as a gesture of offering your life to the Lord. As the music begins and the altar is open for those of you who want to come. Come giving thanks. Come surrendering. Come repenting as a symbol of responding to the call of the Lord. Amen. No one should be pressured. Come willingly. Altar is open. Maybe husband and wife, you can come. Blessed be your name, Lord. From the balcony, it's a long trip, pero you don't have to come down here. God knows our heart.
Through Christ who gives me strength. But sometimes I wonder what He can do through me. No great success to show, no glory of my own, yet in my weakness He is there to let me know. His strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on. In His power, the weak become strong.
Amen, amen.
His strength is perfect. His strength is perfect.
Amen.
We can only know the power that He holds when we truly see how deep our weakness goes.
Yes,
His strength in us begins.
Amen.
Where ours comes to an end, He hears our heart and proves again. His strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on. Raising His power, the weak become strong.
Amen, amen.
His strength is perfect. His strength is perfect. Raised in His power, the weak become strong. His strength is perfect. His strength is perfect.
Dismiss us this morning, Heavenly Father. Klaro kayo imong ipakita sa moa that obedience is honored by you, and the obedience you honor is the obedience done in your strength. So Lord, here we are. We have partaken communion. It is our desire. Before you call us home, give us the chance to walk in obedience. Is church supposed to be dead already? Amen. Pero God, you had mercy on Chinese Baptist Church. Like Lazarus, you called her out of the tomb. Chai Bab, come out. And now we are alive. We have nothing to say. To God be the glory. And every one of us, help us aspire, make it a spiritual ambition to be an obedient church. In the name of Christ, humbly we pray. Amen. You know why we raise our hands? We're helpless. Lord, have mercy. Hear our prayers, O Lord. Give to us what you only can receive. We cannot explain. We humbly receive. Hear our prayer.
Incline thy ear to us
and grant us thy peace. Would you turn to your right, to your left, and at the back and say, I'm glad you're here. God's grace be with you. God's grace be with you all. God's grace be with you. Thank you for coming to church today. The service has come to an end. If you need prayer, the pastors in front and deacons will pray with you. Give your offering with a cheerful heart. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless you all.